ever until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, we have the fruits of the Spirit growing inwardly as we wait eagerly for adoption as sons, the redemption of our lives. Bring us hope, we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes what he sees? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness. For we do not know what to pray for as we ought. But the Spirit himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And he who searches hearts knows what is in the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
child to grasp that. But it's amazing how many people don't want to grasp that simple concept. Instead, they go, well, how do we know it's really the true God? Could be a lot of God. We've got a God, that person has a God, those people over there have a God. It could all work. You know, it's like saying you could buy stuff at the time of your mind. Or they go, well, you know, maybe there is no God at all, maybe there is no afterlife at all, who knows? But if there is something afterwards, well, I'll probably get rewarded somehow, some way, because I am a pretty good guy. You know, I try my best. So you got another currency going on. None of that works. Only through Jesus Christ is our sins forgiven. And the challenge in our life is that, like stalks of wheat in a field, we're surrounded by those who think much differently than we do. And their destination is not going to be a happy place. Now, God has given us the responsibility to face these obstacles and try to share with them the truth of God's Word, the truth that Jesus Christ is the Savior. But on that day, when the end of the age comes, those who have resisted God, who have rejected God, who have decided they have their own interests of life, well, they will get what they have insisted on throughout their life: a separation from God for all eternity. And for those who look to Christ, the Lord and Savior, who hear His word and follow Him, who keep their eyes on Jesus, the perfecter and author of our faith, to them, to Jesus, they will find their soul's salvation. So patience is the watchword for our text this morning. As we wait for God's perfect justice to take place, the opposition is there, but they will be sent away. And so the concerns are not so much for those darnels out there, those tares out there, the weeds out there. Our concern is what Martin Luther brought up in the first of his 95 theses. When our Lord and Master Jesus Christ said, repent, He willed the entire life of believers to be one of repentance. So it's not our job to look for the logs out of people's eyes. Our job is to be concerned about the specks in our own eyes and to seek the forgiveness that is ours only through Jesus Christ. The man of the harvest calls us to be faithful. We hear those words in Luther's great hymn, "My Fortress Is Our God." Though devils all the world are filled, all eager to devour us, we don't lose heart because we keep our eyes on Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, the one who is victorious for us. In His name, amen. Now, you will notice that I did not bring up any stories about my gardening meals and road because I thought it would be nice to have a little shorter sermon this Sunday, and I thought it was going to be a lot better than it is now. Please write to me. Thank you.
our prayer.
For those who are out of work and seeking employment, for those who are traveling this week, we especially remember our Orleans Val, who will be ending her service here at St. Peter's at the end of the month and moving back to Michigan. We ask your blessing upon her as she relocates and finds other ways to serve you through the gift of her music. Lord, in your mercy,
our prayer.
Lord, source of all that is good, mercifully bear our prayers in Jesus' name, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
With thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is meet and right so to do.
It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who on this day overcame death and the grave, and by his glorious resurrection opened to us the way of everlasting life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying,
Amen. Thank you.